I can't remember how I came to do the Whistle and I'll Come to You by M.R. James. I mean, I've never been particularly interested in ghosts. I'm interested in the sociology and the social anthropology of ghosts, of what belief in ghosts consists of and what they represent in terms of mental constructs. That was very fascinating to me. And so I took the story of M.R. James and modified it tremendously. I didn't do it. I didn't literally recreate it as James wrote had written it, because actually it's rather a mandarin sort of Cambridge Dons piece. But it was an opportunity for talking about what it would have been like to have been a rational intellectual suddenly exposed to possibly his own fears of the supernatural. And I was lucky enough to get Michael Hordern to do it, and he played it brilliantly. I completely rewrote all the conversations, and of course then was attacked by another sort of English gent for whom I would have been, but we couldn't put it in those words, a sort of trendy Jew, and that was Kingsley Amis, who just attacked it violently.